So how about I just did like the best intro and the best video and I forgot to hit record. So we're gonna try this again. Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. Space seems to be the biggest concern when it comes to model railroading because we feel like we don't have enough space. But in this video, I'm going to show you 5 industries that don't require a lot of space. So no matter what scale, you're gonna love this video. In this video, I'm gonna show you that some of these industries get away with simply getting 1 car. Maybe 2, but you can do the same. You don't need a lot of space to model these 5 industries. So here we go. Industry number 1 is the scrap industry. Now, yes, I have filmed a lot of videos, especially my steel mill series, where I show these big scrap yards. But don't forget, I filmed Keystone Iron and Metal, which only gets 1 empty gondola. And it's only maybe a few times a month or, you know, maybe like once a week that we give them an empty gondola. They bring the scrap in and the steel in through trucks. They crush it all up. They make it the right size, whatever the customer needs. They put it into a gondola and then we pick it up and take it to the steel mill. So it's easy, simple operation. Now look, there's no huge building. There's not a lot of tracks. It's simply a track and there's a little tiny place that they can simply load the scrap into the gondola. So keep it simple. Also try to keep your industries close to the main lines. Gotta remind you that all the time. So once again, number 1 is the scrap industry. The next industry is a little on the generic, a little on the vague side, but really it's anything that deals with tank cars. So here we see Neville Island. And Neville Island, yeah, it looks intimidating, right? But the truth is there's only a few tracks and we have what's known as spots. So a spot is going to be the place where the industry wants that car placed or spotted. And if there's already a car there, let's just say there's an empty tank car that is ready to be pulled. We will go simply with a 1 engine, pull that empty car out, set it over to a track. We'll grab our load and spot it at that spot. And the conductor, he's going to be there and he's going to say, hey, come on back. 2 car lengths. Now a car length is 50 feet. So I know I'm going about 100 feet. And then he'll count me down 2 car lengths, 1 car length, down to 10 feet, 5 feet, even down to a few inches. Because we need that tank car spotted exact. So then he'll tie the brakes on that car and I'll cut away. And then the industry, they can use the hoses either on the top to load or the bottom to unload. And that's how we spot cars. A lot of fun with model railroading operations that you can do. You don't need a lot. So what's in the tank cars? That's a great question because tank cars can carry everything from liquid to gas. So yeah, you got a good variety of ideas. You can make anything, whether you're making chemicals, whether you're making paint, or whether you're making soda pop. So yes, you can. It doesn't have to be hazmat. You can have a tank car of corn syrup. You can have a tank car of water, just whatever you want. And it's a lot of fun for the operations, a lot of fun to model. It doesn't require a lot of space, doesn't require a lot of cars, has that little bit of mystery about what's in that tank car. And I think you're really gonna enjoy modeling anything dealing with tank cars. Industry number 3 is the produce industry. I don't think I've ever talked about this really. I filmed some cool stuff. So here we have US food and simply it is 1 track. We don't need no big yard. We are going to come around the side of a building and spot a box car. Now, what kind of box car? Let's think about this. You can have just a standard box car if we are shipping canned goods, but if we are shipping things that need refrigerated, like produce, you know, your fruits and vegetables, and maybe your ice cream, all that good stuff that I stopped eating. So if you want to model that, you can get refrigerated cars. But yeah, the whole food industry is something that I don't see people modeled. Now the buildings don't have to be anything really out of the ordinary, just a simple building with a loading door. Now, here is some video that I've filmed over the years that show different places where they get a boxcar of food, or they can get a boxcar of cardboard and packaging material, things like that. So there's so much variety, but yes, you're gonna have your boxcars along the side of a building, and you can model the food industry, the produce industry. Like I said, whether it's gonna be cold where you want your refrigerated boxcars, or if you just want a standard boxcar of packaging material or canned goods, there's so much opportunity to model the food industry. Pretty cool, huh? Never thought about that. Everyone's always modeling coal and gravel. The next industry is, once again, a little on the generic side, a little on the vague side, but it's really anything dealing with specialty steel and steel products. So let's take a look at this footage right here. This is Glassport. And so we have the main line. We have a siding which is near all the buildings. And way back, 1999, I was a conductor trainee, and we gave this building, and I don't remember the name of it, it's been that long, we gave them one gondola of steel. Now that steel can be in the form of maybe steel slabs or even what's known as billets, but that industry, we set a gondola into the side of this building and they removed the steel. They made something out of that product. Not sure, but I'll always remember that as an industry that only needed one gondola. Here we see Taggart. And Taggart, we give them one, sometimes two gondolas of steel, and then they mold it into weights. Yeah, steel weights, counterweights is what I was told. So it's something that is so easy to model. You can give them steel slabs, you can give them steel billets, and then pull the empties out. They don't require a lot, they don't need serviced often, but it's something that is just so easy to model. So yeah, anything like along that line is simply gonna be a easy gondola for you. Make some steel loads, and I have videos about how to make some steel loads yourself. So modeling the specialty steel is a great idea. The next industry is the transfer facility. And a transfer facility is just that. They are transferring the product from a truck to rail, rail to truck, even rail to river. Ah, a lot of cool ideas now. Okay, so we're transferring. Why do we need one of those? Why do we need one? Well, let's think about it. It's 2022 and not every industry has a railroad track connected to it. So they're gonna send the stuff by truck through the town to a transfer facility. From there, the product gets loaded into a rail car and can be sent across the United States. And maybe the person that is getting that has the ability to unload it by rail, or maybe they have to have a transfer facility out there. There are so many modeling opportunities. So yes, you can get away with flat cars. You can get away with box cars, tank cars, even covered hoppers. Transfer facilities, they could be covered or uncovered. Here we're looking at Bell Transfer in Braddock, PA. And we can give them boxcars of stuff. We can give them product that gets loaded onto barges. So yeah, you can do truck to rail, rail to river, all in one area. There are so many different opportunities to just have some fun. It's probably the most versatile thing you could put on a layout. So model a transfer facility. All right, so thank you for watching this video. That was five industries that you can model that don't require a lot of space. In the future video, you will see some really cool freight cars for these industries. So yeah, you definitely want to subscribe if you haven't. Hit that bell icon to be notified of future videos. You can also follow me on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and Patreon and all that stuff under DJ's Trains. My website, DJSTRAINS.com. Yeah, cool stuff coming up. A lot of cool drone footage. And maybe I'll get back to working on my layout. So, all right, thank you guys so much. And I'll see you in the next video. This was a hard one to film, man. I was screwing up. I must have had like 100 takes, 100 bloopers. Yeah. So, how about the cool fall? How about the cool fall footage? I cannot talk today. Something's wrong with me. Bye.